Grantham's historic land swap begins tomorrow with flood victims taking part in a ballot. But small businesses in the Lockyer Valley have been left high and dry. Another one folded just this week.
Ray White Gatton, a top real estate provider for decades, now in liquidation.
For a number of months, they had virtually no income. You know, we had businesses in Gatton that were losing $500,000 a week.
Owners say house sales have slumped 75% since the floods and they haven't received any government help.
When you think about that, that's very difficult.
While businesses crawl slowly back, Lockyer Valley locals are about to take a major step forward.
Tomorrow really does offer a whole new start.
It gives a lot of people the opportunity, like if they want to physically move there, they can move there, and that's a good thing.
Moving to higher ground will mean entering a ballot. Flood victims can order their preferences for parcels of land the same size as their own. The fairest way, says the council.
If you based it on merit, as you would call it, some of these people may tell a better story than their neighbour, and that wouldn't really be fair.
Even on stumps, Bill Jones had a metre of water through his home. Now he's moving on up.
Looking to the north, the east and the west, and the south was just all water, and that's not a, wasn't a very nice experience.
We would expect about 70 odd households, which is probably about 10 more than we thought.
Some though can't look forward to a new start. The blocks available too small for people with farms or paddocks.
People that depend on the land to make their living, no, they can't live in a little house.
But for a region that's been through so much, things are starting to look up. Renee Henry, 10 News.